President Marcos hitting back at his predecessor for criticizing his recent trips abroad. Speaking to reporters in Germany, Marcos said his travels are for business and not for sightseeing.
Ito yung schedule ko. Saan yung pasyal? This is my schedule for today. Where's the paseo? Wala. You know, yung kasama ko, yung kasama nyo kami, you know, we don't make pasyal. Even in the places that I know or I've spent a lot of time with, hindi ko napupuntahan yung mga dati kong pinupuntahan because we're here to do this.
Marcos made that remark after former President Duterte claimed his overseas trips were mostly for leisure. This was the latest exchange between the two leaders, the first one in January, when Duterte claimed Marcos was a drug addict. In an allegation, the former president later took back. Now, amid this, House Deputy Majority Leader Janet Garin told Duterte he should exercise caution when issuing statements against his successor, as his words may put the Philippines in a bad light.
Sa Amerika, pag nagsasalita si President Barack Obama, medyo minsan pag nag-criticize siya sa gobyerno, linalagay niya sa tuwid, parang may basis ka talaga. So, yan lang yung sana medyo mabago ito. Kasi pwede siyang naging nakakatawa dun sa mga kaharap mo, pero dahil pag lumabas siya sa general public through media, iba yung dating. And statements like that can actually diminish the respect of other countries to our country. Hindi ang pagkatao ni President BBM ang natetente, ang nababastos yung pagkatao ng buong Pilipinas.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos now in the Czech Republic for a four-day state visit. President Marcos is expected to meet with Czech Republic President Peter Pavel, as well as three other constitutional heads of government. He is also expected to sign a deal on the establishment of labor consultation mechanisms that aim to elevate cooperation between the two countries for the safe and orderly migration of Filipino workers. Before departing for a Central European country, Marcos confirmed he will be meeting with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken on March 19. Now, a possible meeting with the U.S. and Japan also being finalized.
The intention is to continue to plan to strengthen the cooperation between the three countries, the United States, Japan, and the Philippines. We will perhaps formalize it, but we at this point, we are still, that's part of the discussion that we will be having. To exactly what will be put in any such agreement.
The Philippine House of Representatives set to investigate the construction of the controversial resort built in the middle of the Chocolate Hills in Bohol. House Deputy Majority Leader Erwin Turfo says he will file a motu proprio inquiry on the matter, vowing to exact accountability for the desecration of a heritage site, which he likened to a wart.
Yun po ay diniklara ng National Heritage. Kahit ano po ang palusot nung daldal po ng daldal sa social media yung kanilang manager doon. Sinasabi niya, hindi naman daw nila ginalaw yung Chocolate Hills. The mere fact na nandun ka, tinignan ko nga, hindi nga nila ginalaw, nasa gitna sila ng dalawang hill. Sinira ho nila yung view. Actually, para makita mo na maganda yung hill na yan, may kaakyating ka parang tore, parang makikita mo yung view. Ngayon, ang pangit na hong tignan. Pag nasa aerial shots ka, ang pangit din. Para siyang kulugo, di ba? Tumubong kulugo sa mukha mo, okay? So ang pangit to eh, kahit anong palusot.
The manager of the resort, Julieta Sablas, had told ABS-CBN News they were given a clearance to operate as long as they secure an environment compliance certificate. But she admitted they failed to obtain an ECC because it slipped her mind during the pandemic. The local government of Sagbayan Bohol today revoked the business permit of the resort. More American investments coming into the Philippines. New York-based investment firm KKR and Company Inc. is pouring in $400 million, or about 22 billion pesos for the development and acquisition of around 2,000 telco towers in the country. This is part of KKR's investments in Pinnacle Towers, the largest independent telecommunication tower operator in the Philippines. Meanwhile, Maryland-based clean energy company Ally Power is partnering with the Manny Pangilinan-led Empower, the local retail electricity supplier of Manila Electric Company, or Meralco. The two firms have entered into a $400 million deal to build a hydrogen and electric refueling station.